The greatest reason for weakness of iman is being detached from the book of Allah and the sunnah of his Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. This is number one. This will kill you every single time. If you are detached from the book of Allah, meaning you don't read it, you don't ponder upon its meanings, you don't memorize it, you don't try to implement it in your life, then you cannot be wondering why your iman is weak, because you have no attachment to Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said, I leave behind me two things. If you hold to them, you will never go astray. The first of them is the book of Allah, which is like a rope. One end of it with Allah Azza wa Jal and the other end of it in your hands. If you let go of that rope, then you lose your connection with Allah Azza wa Jal. You have to continue to keep that connection with the book of Allah. The only way we know Allah is by that which He has revealed to us about Himself. And where else are you going to find that which Allah has revealed to us about Himself other than in His Word? Other than in His Word. This is the words of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is as close as you're going to get to being near to Allah in this life, is through your connection to Allah through His book. Because even in our salah, people say, yeah, our salah is our connection with Allah. Is there any salah that is valid without the book of Allah in it? Is there any salah that is valid without the book of Allah being in it? So you can't tell me that salah is the only connection you have with Allah, because if you don't have the book, then you don't have the salah. So the book of Allah Azza wa Jal is the most important thing. It is primary. It is primary. I can't stress the importance enough that if you don't pick up the Quran at least once a day, in the morning or in the evening or any time, and at least thumb through something and try to understand it, then you have lost a severe connection with Allah Azza wa Jal. You've lost it. And if you just read the Arabic, mashallah, may Allah reward you with the hasanat of every single letter you read. But if you don't understand it, what is it going to do for you? You don't know what Allah is even telling you. You are saying something that Allah is commanding you, and you don't even understand it. It's like you sitting here speaking, if I gave this language in a language that I made up, you wouldn't benefit from it, and I wouldn't know what I'm saying. So no one's going to get benefit from this. You get benefit from the book of Allah through its recitation and its understanding. You get the hasanat through its recitation, excuse me, and you get benefit through its understanding. Allah says in Surah Al-Furqan, glory be to Him who has revealed this book unto a slave. For what reason? لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَذِيرًا. So that it can become to mankind a warning. Not just so that it can become to mankind a qirat, a recitation. It is to be to mankind a warning. A warning. The first verse revealed to the Prophet ﷺ after اقرأ بِسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقْ was what? يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَثِّرُ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Get up and go warn someone about me. The Quran is supposed to warn us. It's supposed to advise us. It's supposed to encourage us. طموحنا غدنا والوعد والأمل طموحنا جيل إلى العلا يصل طموحنا غدنا